Hey guys, welcome back to Dynamic Coding. My name is Yogesh Singh and in this tutorial we are finally completing this paint application. As you can see, we only create a GUI of our paint application in our last tutorial, but in this tutorial we are working on its function and draw something on it and save them also. So when I drag my mouse, you can see nothing is happening on the canvas. Okay, so for drawing something on the canvas, first we have to bind our canvas with a function. So I am using self.canvas.bind method. In bind method, I have to pass a value b1 motion. B1 motion means the motion of my mouse or when I click left button of mouse. So when I press on or click my left button of mouse and drag the cursor, a function name as self.paint is created. Okay, so a function name self.paint is created, but I use the function, but I also have to create it. So self define paint and here print like mouse is dragged. Okay, so when I run the code, this is examples for showing the indentation level. Okay, this is an error in one space. GUI. As you can see, when I dragged my mouse cursor, the paint function is called many time. Okay, it's take now paint take one position argument, but two are given. This is error because I did not pass a variable which is event. The event is because the dragging of mouse is a event in tkinter. So for calling a function with by event, we also have to pass a event variable in the function. So when I again run the code, again drag the mouse, you can see mouse is dragged, it printed many times. It means the function is called many times. Okay, so I am just removing this and now I have to draw something. For that I use four variable. X1 comma y1 is equal to event dot x minus 2 comma in brackets event dot y minus 2 and just copy this line, control C, control V. In the place of minus use plus and in the place of y1 use y2 and x1 use x2. So what does this mean? So it actually gives the value of area on which I start dragging the mouse and from at which place I stop dragging it. For I have four variables now. Use a method of canvas which is self.canvas.createOver. CreateOver takes mainly four arguments, x1 comma y1 comma x2 comma y2. Then the next thing is fill. The color I want to fill on my canvas is black. Oval is black by default. The color I want is black. Then outline is also black. Then width means pen size or brush size which is self dot pen size dot get. So pen size is a variable which I created in the past tutorial or in the previous video, pen size here, okay. So when I run this code, okay, the GUI comes. When I drag the mouse, you can see I am able to draw some lines on my canvas. And when I use the scale bar and increase the width, and you can see the value of our, actually the brush size is also increases. Now I have to use this color boxes or color button to change the color of my pen. For this, first create two variable. The first variable, only one variable at this time, self dot pen underscore color. And here I also have to pass self dot pen color because I don't want the outline color or the fill color of pen should be different color. So create this variable in important things area, self dot pen underscore color. The default color of pen should be black, okay. Now for using those buttons, I have to create or pass a function in the button area, which is here. Command is equal to lambda col equal to color is equal to color colon, here not I have to pass colon, self dot select underscore color, in this I have to pass col. So what this line or code do? So when I select any button of the color frame, a command is called which is, or a function is called which is self dot select color, and here I pass a value col. Col is the value of color of which button is pressed, okay. After that I have to create this function. So def select underscore color, here I have to also pass col because I am passing it now, I have to get it now. Self dot pen color is equal to col, that's all. When I run the code, go down now. When I run the code, the default color of our brush is black because I choose black color as my default color in pen size. Now when I click on this red color, you can see the color is changed to red, okay. Now the next thing is I have to call my eraser function. So making eraser function is not so difficult, just use def eraser, just use self dot pen color is equal to white, and when I run this, as you can see I am drawing some lines, increase the size, I use yellow color and draw something unusual. When I click on eraser, you can see, okay, the eraser color is also येल्लो, तो समथिंग इज रॉन्ग हेयर. सेल्फ डॉट पेन कलर इज इक्वल टू वाइट. ओके सेल्फ डॉट पेन. ओके द इरेजर बटन इज नॉट प्रेस करेक्टली. व्हेन आई क्लिक ऑन ब्लू एंड व्हेन आई क्लिक ऑन इरेजर इज ऑल्सो गिविंग ब्लू. ओके द थिंग इज आई डिड नॉट कॉल दैट फंक्शन. सो इन द इरेजर बटन प्लेस आई हैव टू कॉल द फंक्शन. आफ्टर दैट द कमांड और मेथड विल परफॉर्म. तो सेल्फ डॉट इरेजर नाउ दिस विल रन एंड इरेज माई. क्लिक ऑन रेड इंक्रीज द वेट. यू कैन सी आई एम ड्रॉइंग थिंग्स. Now increase decrease the size and call eraser function. You can see it is erasing my color, or actually it is just drawing white lines on my canvas, so it looks like it's erasing the color. Now we can also change the eraser size using this scale bar, because the eraser and the pen color is create by or draw by the same function, which is paint. Now the new thing is, or next thing is, canvas color. So for creating canvas color, I have to use a function, create a function first, canvas underscore color. Here I have to use first pass here and call the function as well, self dot canvas color. Now I call the function. I have to import something like from pkinter import color chooser. Okay, so here in the canvas color function I have to use like color color is equal to color chooser dot ask color. Okay, so this variable gives, or this function gives, opens a dialog box for us for choosing the color. Okay, now if when I print color, when I click on canvas, as you can see a dialog box is open for selecting a color. When I click on this green color and press OK, a tuple of color is returned. So for using that color, the color of that is, as you can see, the color is RGB and a hexadecimal value. We can use RGB or hexadecimal value, but I am using hexadecimal value. You can use your RGB value as well. For using RGB hexadecimal value, I have to pass a index of 1. Again, when I click on canvas, green but color, and here only the hexadecimal value is returned. Now just change the canvas color. For changing the canvas color, just use self dot, I'm removing this, self dot canvas dot configure background is equal to color 1. Now again click on canvas, select this red color, click on OK. Now you can see the canvas color is changed to red, and we can draw some other thing. But when I click on eraser, you can see this create a problem. So I have to make my eraser like that it change the color according to the canvas. This is also easy. Just here I have to pass a new variable self dot ser underscore color. Okay. Just create this variable self dot eraser underscores. LOR eraser color is equal to white. And now in the canvas color function, change the eraser color value to COLOR color 1. Now when I run, change the canvas color to sky blue. And when I draw something, increase the size. Okay, when I click on eraser, as you can see, the eraser color is also changed, and it looks like looks so great. Now the next thing is clear button. So clear button performs the activity when I click on clear, it clear all my drawings or which I made on canvas on a single click. For this I have to pass a lambda function, which is lambda, I increase the font size, okay. So lambda colon, here I have to pass self dot canvas dot delete, here I have to pass all. So what is this function do? So when I click on my clear button, it's call a function which is a built-in function for canvas, canvas dot delete, and the argument is passed which is all. It means remove all the things in the canvas. So when I click, draw some lines, okay, and when I click on clear, you can see instead of using eraser, I can also use my clear function for removing all the things from canvas. Now the last step for my video is save button. Okay, so for using save button, we first have to import the library, which is below. Decrease my font size now. Okay, you can use install Philo by going to terminal, and here you can use pip install Philo, or you can like pip install Philo. I already installed it, so I am not installing it, but you can use this method or go to setting and get project interpreter and then select search for Philo and install it. So I am using from PIL from pil.imagegrab. Dot I image grab import import. Okay, I'm using correct statement, control V, import pill dot image grab as image grab. So image grab is a method which is class, you can say, which is used to grab a image from our take interface window or any window. For first I have to create a save function, and now the main thing start. So for saving a function, I also have to use a tkinter class, which is file dialog and message box. File dialog is getting the information from which file I have to save and at which location, and message box is used for giving a message to the user that the image is saved. Or in save, I have to use a try catch, then try try. I use cross, then here file is equal to, instead of writing this, I just copy and describe each function step by step to you. Control C, paint tutorial, Control V. So what this flowing save button, save function is doing? So file equal to arg save file as file name, default extension equal to jpg. It means it opens a prompt or a dialog box which asks a user for a location and file name, and when the user click on save, the default extension for my file should be .jpg. After that, x equal to self.winfo, wininfo, root x, and canvas winfo x. This will give the position of canvas and root window, and the y variable is used to store the position of root window from y direction and canvas at y axis, or y, here I use y direction here. This both the function gives the value of my paint and describe, and actually this is doing only this, it is pass returning the value of my paint application and canvas onto this, on two variable x and y. Now x1 and y1 is used to store the height and width. Here x1 is used for storing the width of my canvas and y1 is used to storing the height of my canvas. So when I use image grab dot grab, image grab is a class and grab function is a method of image grab. Then crop means it starts from the where the canvas is located, x and y, and how after that how much area it has to cover. So x1 gives the width and y1 gives the height of that area. And save dot file name, file name is a variable which I use for getting the name and location of my save file or image. Now a message box dot show info gives a paint say image is saved as str file name. It's open a gives a message box which show image is saved, and in accept I also pass message box dot show error here paint says unable to save image something went wrong. Okay, so when I run this, stop and return. Where is the paint? It is taking so much time. Again running it. Maybe it is not coming, process is happening. Oh, this is come. Now, when I draw something like, since the first use eraser, instead of eraser, I can use clear function. Okay, use eraser first. Then, I am drawing some line like subscribe. Okay. Now when I click on save, actually this I call the save function. No, oh shit, I have to draw this again. Then self dot save, just again run it. Now instead of save, here I'm using like it. Okay, when I click on save, unable to save image, something went long. So try function is not working. Let's check why. File dialog message box, file image dot image graph. So I will check my something is wrong with pillow library, I think. Go to setting. Hey guys, now I get the error. This error is come because I create a save function and the default function for image graph is also saved. This is the reason why my function is not saving that, because the save, when I use save, it is calling that method and it did not take any value. So it creates a confusion while saving that image. Now I have to use self.save_paint because I change the name of variable to save paint. And when I run this code, where is it? I don't know why it is taking so much time for coming. Come buddy, come. Come. Again running this. Oh, it comes. Now, when I draw something, what is the problem with this system? Increasing the width. No, color will change. Okay, I don't know what is this, because I am saving this. Unable to save image, something went wrong again. So what the problem comes again? Instead of doing this, I just copy this control C, paste in my control P. Okay, self saved underscore paint. Save underscore paint. Again, try to run it. Cancel. Again, it will take too much time. Okay, draw some lines.
increase the width. I can click on save. The thing is, I only use here pass. I can use print, not save. Wrong. Okay. So where is the error is coming? Even I am not able to find it. Again run. Draw something. Click on save. Unable to, not save. Something went wrong. Okay, file name, I'll save as file name. Then save file name, image.x1, y1.save file, str file name. Okay, so try to print each value. It will help us to know from which line gives us error. Actually, I use this value. Because I also getting error while doing this. Again, then save. Okay, again click on save. Error comes. Now, not save, something went wrong. So it is giving error. Okay, the error is, I'm such a fool. File dialog dot arc save file name. I did not use file dialog here. I am calling its method arc file save name. Then I am again try to draw something like a king crown. Not look like crown. These are rubies and diamond in it. When I click on save. Now it is running. As you can see, a dialog box is open. I am selecting my default place for saving it is desktop. Now test3.jpg, or instead of jpg use test.3, and message box comes image is saved at desktop name test.jpg. As I use default extension is test.jpg, when I click OK, exit my PyCharm, you can see test3.jpg is come on my screen and it will look great, but my system is hanging, so I'm not opening this. So that's all for this video. If you have any doubt, you can drop a message on comment section, and you can also message me on Instagram. The link for Instagram channel is in description, and for other videos and future videos, you can subscribe to my channel and share it also. Thank you. Bye.